And these are the interests that have it. So not only are they dealing with familiar faces in many cases of former staffers, people who they know and who they have, presumably have a certain comfort level with, but those people are also in a position to steer them to the campaign contributions they need to stay in Washington.
You begin with a story of David Nixon. Tell us what his problem is.
Well, David Nixon is the vice president for policy for AdvaMed, which is the one of two large, representatives or trade groups for device makers, artificial hips and stents and people who make products like that. He, by the way, is a very highly respected figure. He's a PhD in economics and was an advisor to Ted Kennedy for many years before he moved into working for AdvaMed a few years ago. But they were, unlike some of the other interests in Washington, pharma most notably, which made a deal very early on saying we'll contribute $80 billion, I think the number was, to the health care deal, the money that's needed to expand coverage. The device makers didn't make a deal early on, so near the end of the process, they were hit with a $40 billion tax. And Exxon basically was in a position to help persuade lawmakers to whittle that down to $20 billion. It's still a lot of money, but it's a lot less than $40 billion. And he was, I mean, he's a good example of somebody with just an absolutely first-class pedigree who is extremely valuable to a corporate interest on the Hill, obviously. And working with him, we counted at least 14 lobbyists who had Hill experience, including, I think, about 10 who worked on the committees involved in shaping legislation. So you have somebody who has an extremely high level of credibility just because of his work on the Hill previously, and then he's assisted by all these people who have connections on the various committees. So it was a situation where you've got, as I mentioned earlier, that combination of expertise and also connections.
Andrew Zajac, you not only have, you know, the access, of course, that these former staffers for people like Max Baucus, who then go to lobby and can come back and they know their, you know, boss as well on Capitol Hill, but you have what they do as staffers, that period leading up to when they go to be lobbyists. For example, Billy Towson, the former congressman, extremely powerful in shaping the drug legislation, then becomes head of pharma. Can you talk about the significance of that?
Well, that caused such a storm of controversy that I think there was at least some cosmetic changes. I believe there were restrictions placed on the access that lobbyists would have to the House floor. I believe there were some efforts to restrict the most visible elements of access. Once Representative Towson went over and became the head of pharma. He's a classic example because that was a very, very generous drug benefit, and it included the provision that Medicare could not negotiate on price. So essentially, it was very, very lucrative to pharmaceutical companies and very expensive to the public treasury and to citizens. And Towson is a very good example of a sort of a high-profile person from Congress. There are other examples, I think. Richard Baker, a former chair of one of the House Financial Services Committee, is the head of the Hedge Fund Association, as another example. Just tremendous value to the expertise that these people have.
And so finally, Andrew Zajac, your conclusion, as President Obama talks about, well, the legislation that was just passed, it's got three hurdles. The first two have been just passed just in the last 5 minutes. The Senate Democrats cleared the second of the 360-vote hurdles on President Obama's health care overhaul that just took place, when he says this is a great victory over special interests.
He may be overstating it a little bit. I think it's a half a loaf. I think he understands that. I think he needs to try to sell it this way. But I don't think it's his way of doing the bill, of trying to get a bill, was to bring all the special interests to the table. So it's heavily shaped by special interests. There's no other way of looking at it, really.
Well, we will link to your report, Andrew Zajac, national correspondent for Tribune Newspapers. The number of lobbyists that come from the most powerful men in Congress right now, in the Senate and the House, who are shaping health care reform. Also, that number of more than $600 million over the last 2 years spent on lobbying. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. When we come back, we go from health care to global warming. We'll be joined by the nation's leading climatologist, by Jim Hansen, who's written a new book called Storms of My Grandchildren. We'll find out why he didn't go to the Copenhagen Climate Conference. Stay with us. This is Democracy Now!